Hey everyone, welcome to GN Electric YouTube channel. Comparison of technical data for wires of two world-class integrated amplifier. AQPS E280 against Yamaha AS2200. Let's follow. Both have the same output power of 90 watt into 8 ohm speaker per channel. They differ 30 watt per channel into 4 ohm speakers. 30 watts is a fantastic number, isn't it? Many people are interested and prefer if an integrated amplifier has more weight. The Yamaha integrated amplifier AS2200 weighs 5 pounds more than the AQ phase. Total power consumption is the amount of electrical energy such in by the device as measured at the main input. The AQPS is apparently more energy efficient than the Yamaha. Total power consumption when idle is how much energy is used by this device when there is no input signal. The AQPS saves 15 watts of electrical energy. The use of the transformer and integrated amplifier is for step down. Yamaha has a transformer capacity of 625 VA and the toroidal type is more efficient. This basically indicates the amplifier's ability to control overshoot of the loudspeaker, i.e. to stop off cone from moving. The damping factor of the AQ phase is 500. It is better than the Yamaha. The capacitor in an integrated amplifier is to filter direct current which still has the ripple from the output of rectifier diode. Yamaha has 28,000 microfarad, more than AQ phase. With a capacity of 90 watt per channel, larger integrated amplifier tend to attract more attention. The volume of the AQPS is greater than that of the Yamaha. The most critical component in an integrated amplifier is the transistor, and I would prefer that two pairs of transistor are better than one pair of transistor, even though both have the same current capacity. Each of these two integrated amplifiers have a different color characteristic. Yamaha offers two color choices, black and silver, AQPS only gold. THD is the measure of the deviation of voltage or current waveform from ideal sinusoidal shape. The total harmonic distortion of the AQPS is better than Yamaha. Signal-to-noise ratio. The correct way to determine the signal-to-noise ratio is to short-circuit the input. The AQPS is 8 dB better than the Yamaha. The best frequency response is an accordance which the audio frequency range between 20 to 20 kHz. Yamaha is better plus and minus 0.1 dB. It will be said that an amplifier is good if the output of the final transistor is not connected directly to the loudspeaker. And I prefer that coupling use a mechanical relay rather than a MOSFET semiconductor. The tone control characteristic by both amplifiers are almost the same, but there are slight differences. The AQPS has gained at 1 dB better than the Yamaha. Usually, buyers also pay attention to the total input on an integrated amplifier. AQPS has 8 inputs while Yamaha only has 7 inputs. There is one button that Yamaha does not have, namely the recorder button, which is only found on AQPS. And it would be better if I had to wait. It would be nice if Yamaha installed this button. In this digital era, it would be nice if your device had a digital input signal facility. AQPS already has a slot for converting digital signal to analog, while Yamaha does not yet. Many people don't know the function of this compensate button. By pressing the compensate button when you decreasing the volume, the bass sound will still sound better. And not everyone likes stereo signal. This will give you headache, right? Because AQPS install a mono button on the front panel, while Yamaha does not have it. There is one button facility that AQPS does not have, namely the headphone volume button. Yamaha has installed it well. The volume of the headphone can be adjusted by trim. Having a mute button is important when you need it suddenly. AQPS does not have this mute button facility, whereas Yamaha already has it. If you are in Japan and you will see that the price offered is cheaper than in other country. AQPS is priced at $2,680. Yamaha is priced at $2,775. For more detail, I will present a block diagram of two integrated amplifiers. Each has weaknesses and advantages. The final assessment is on the melodiousness on the sound produced. When we look at the integrated amplifier from the front, it is very good. Other perspective do too. And on the back of the panel, there are several port and jack. They are connected to input and output. Internal view. This module is responsible for amplification the current. Binding post of printed circuit board. In the input section, there are several relay that will regulate which input will enter. This is a PCB board preamplifier which AQPS know by the name AAVA, which is more super low noise amplifier. AQPS E280 has a block diagram like this. The concept of the output final of the Yamaha integrated amplifier is different from amplifiers in general. Let's quickly see what is inside this Yamaha integrated amplifier. There are four capacitors for the power supply. And also the Yamaha audio integrated amplifier install several electrolytic capacitor component with audio grade quality. And small capacitor use MLCC. 625 volt ampere a toroidal transformer. This microcontroller is the brain of the device which control all other devices. MLE20 MOSFET semiconductor are used one set per channel for final amplifier. A potentiometer which a motor regulates the volume. Based on the data presented earlier, the winner is AQPS E280. Thank you for watching.